Ang mundo ay nababalot ng matematika. San ka man tatanaw, may matematika. Isa sa mga sangay ng matematika ay ang geometriya o mas kilala sa Ingles na geometry. Mula sa paggawa ng bahay, sa mga popular na estruktura gaya ng Eiffel Tower sa Paris, France, Great Wall sa China, at pyramids sa Egypt ay pawang ginagamitan ng geometriya. Ang salitang geometry naman ay nagmula sa salitang Griego na geo na ang ibig sabihin ay earth at metrein na ang ibig sabihin ay to measure o sukatin. Alam nyo ba kung sino ang ama ng geometriya? Well, siya lang naman ang nag-iisang Euclid ng Alexandria, Egypt. Pero wait lang po, hindi siya pag-uusapan natin ngayon. Hindi, ang pag-uusapan natin ay ang kanyang limang axioms at limang postulates sa kanyang librong The Elements. Ready na ba kayo? Kung oo, tara't, tara!
Five axioms and five postulates. Axiom 1. Things which equal the same thing also equal one another.
Axiom number 1. Things which equal the same thing also equal one another. So para masabtan siyang maayo, maghatag tag example and illustration. We have here line segment A and B which is having a measurement of 3 cm. Also, here we have line segment U and B, which is also having a measurement of 3 cm. So, since line segment A and B and then line segment U and B, kay pareha sila measurement, then line segment A and line segment U and B is equal. So, now, magbuhatag isa pa kalahing segment na equal sa line segment U and B. We have line segment X and Y. As we can see, line segment U and B and line segment X and Y is equal. So, since line segment A and line segment U and B is equal, then we can conclude that line segment A and line segment X and Y is also equal.
Axiom 2. If equals are added to equals, then the wholes are equal.
The states that if equals are added to equals, then the wholes are equals. So it is understandable. However, I will be giving you an example to further understand this axiom. So first example, this example is a situational example. So suppose that you have a $9 money. So we assume that this $9, we will put some variables for this. Assume that this $9 is equal to A. And you spent your $9 and you bought a book. So this book cost $9. So we assume that this book is B. So these two are equal to one another. So we assume that these are equal since this book cost $9 and you spent $9 for this book. And second, so assume further that you have $2. So we will put this as the value of C, and you spent your $2 on a pen, so we assume that this is D. So same with this $9 and this book. This you spent your $2 to a pen, and this pen cost $2. So this to R equals. So since in the axiom it stated that if equals are added to equals, then the wholes are equals. So if we add these two, so we will generate A plus C, which equals to $11. And also for this, is equal to the total cost of the item. So since this book costs $9 and this pen costs $2, so we assume that this is also $11. So B plus D, this is the B plus D, which is equal to the wholes of the money you spent. So that's it. So again, I will be giving you an example in a graphical way. So assume that you have a line segment with point A and B, which has a 15 centimeter. And so we will assume that this point AB is A, and this line segment with point CD also have 15 centimeter length is C. C or B. Again, B na lang. These A and B are equal with one another. So, and again, given the line segment with point EF with 10 centimeter as length, we will assume this as C. And again, point GH with the length of 10 centimeter as C. So this C and D are equal. So we assume this equals, if we add that these two equals, the wholes are equal. So since this is the A, B, C, and D, both have a 25 centimeter length as the wholes of this equals. So that's it. In mathematical expression, we say that if A is equal to B and C is equal to D, then A plus C is equal to BD. These are the same with this statement. If equals are added to equals, if equals are added to equals, then the wholes are equals. This is the mathematical expression of this statement. So, or we simply say that this is the addition property. So that's it. Thank you.
Axiom 3. If equals are subtracted from equals, then the remainders are equal.
And for our axiom 3, it is stated that if equals are subtracted from equals, then the remainders are equal. And here is my example. Now, suppose that 8 and H are equal and 5 and E are equal, then C will be equal to 3. So this just means that 8 and H are wholes and 3 and C are remainders. Now, I also have another example here. And let two numbers A and B be equal. And according to the third Euclid's axiom, if equals are subtracted from equals, then the remainders are equal. So let's just suppose that A minus B is equal to B minus A, and this is equal to 0. Clearly, both give the same result, thus the remainder is equal, or the remainders are equal.
Axiom 4. Things which coincide with one another equal one another.
Book of Euclid, Axiom number 4. Things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. So, when we say coincide, this means that to occupy corresponding exact position. So, for example, if two lines coincide with each other, this implies that the length of the two line segment are equal. Since the two lines have the same length, then they are equal. So, when we say if things coincide, then they are equal to one another. That's all. Thank you.
Axiom 5. The whole is greater than the part.
Hello everyone, I'm Jeffry Arig. Let me explain the Axiom 5. The whole is greater than the part. So, for example, this is a sheet of paper. This is a whole sheet of paper. So, if I cut the side of the paper, so this will be the outcome. So this piece of paper is once a part of this paper. So as always, a whole is greater than this piece of paper. This whole sheet of paper is greater than this piece of paper. So a whole is greater than a part.
Postulate number 1. A straight line can be drawn joining any two points.
Postulate number 1. A straight line can be drawn joining any two points. So para masabtan siyang maayo, maghatag tag example and illustration. Here we have two points, point A and point B. So, if i-joint nato ang point A sa point B, makabuo tag straight line. See? Also, here we have naghatag tag isa pa ka point, which is point C. So, if point A, i-connect nato siya sa point C, we also can draw a straight line.
Postulate number 2. A finite straight line can be produced continuously in a straight line.
Which states that a finite straight line can be produced continuously in a straight line. So, the word continuously is the keyword in this postulate. So, to give an example, so in the first postulate, it stated that a straight line can be produced in any two points, connecting any two points. So we say that we have these two points, and we call this point, first point, as the point A and point B. So we can produce a straight line if we connect these two points. So that is, so in the second postulate, recall that the second postulate stated that a finite straight line can be produced continuously in a straight line. So this line AB is a finite straight line. So produce this line on both sides continuously on a straight line. So suppose that this is the continuation of the line of this line. So, and on the other side, that is the straight line. So that's all. Thank you.
Postulate number 3. A circle may be described with any point as center and any distance as a radius.
And for our third postulate, it says that a circle may be described with any point as a center and any distance as a radius. So It just means that if you are given any point as a center and any radius, then it is enough to draw a circle. Just like this. Now let's assume a line segment AB. Then we have to keep the point A fixed and the point B move around the point A. So we will see, and we actually see it right now, that it will create a circle. And the length of the line segment AB will be the radius. So this is the radius.
Postulate number 4. All right angles are equal to one another.
Postulate number 4. All right angles are equal to one another. Right angles are said to be equal to one another if all the right angles are congruent. We can say that the angle is right angle if the two perpendicular straight lines intersect at 90 degrees. So, all right angles are equal to one another by definition. Thank you.
Postulate number 5. That, if a straight line falling on two straight lines makes the interior angles on the same side less than two right angles, the two straight lines, if produced indefinitely, meet on that side on which are the angles less than the two right angles.
Hello again. Let me read to you the last postulate of the book 1. That, if a straight line falling on two straight lines makes the interior angles on the same side less than the two right angles, the two straight lines, if produced indefinitely, meet on that side on which are the angles less than the two right angles. So now I'm going to illustrate the postulate 5. So sabi dito, there is a straight line daw falling on two straight lines. Then it creates an interior angle on the same side. So in the same side, it creates a two less than 90 degree angle, less than right angle. So, and also at the same side also, katong line dito which extends infinitely, mag-meet daw na siya at some point. So, atong mag-draw na tao isa ka line. So, di siya parallel kay... Kung i-parallel na to is... Di ta maka-create og ano, less than right angle. Okay. O, tapos na mag-create po ta og ani. So, so man yung interior angle niya kini turning less than 90 degree angle na siya. No. So at the same, in the same side daw, this line which kung i-extend nato na siya to infinite, mag-meet na siya daw at some point. Example lang niya. At some point, mag-meet daw na siya. Malang. King paghinga, kaya huwag mag-alala, ipikit ang iyong matatana. Pahinga muna, ako nang bahala. Labis pa sa labis ang iyong nagawa, mama. Pahinga muna, ako na.